Hi, I'm Mark Isham, and I'm a film composer, and I've just completed a film titled Gracie.
I'm hearing reservations.
10 yards out for you? Come on, man, it's like hitting the side of a barn.
I won't be the shooter.
At the very end of last year, I received a wonderful letter from a music supervisor, John Houlihan, who introduced himself in this movie called Gracie that was just being finished, directed by Davis Guggenheim. And it was a passionate plea for me to consider their movie. And it's a wonderful movie. The difference in doing a film like Gracie from, let's say, a big action film like Next is that you have to define the scope. This is always an interesting challenge. In a movie like Gracie, you have a young woman, high school age girl, who is embarking onto her must be the biggest challenge of her life. And yet, is she saving the world? Is she conquering other planets? No. So how do you choose a scoring vocabulary for this? Do you score it from the point of view of this is the biggest thing for her in her experience? Or do you try and take it slightly more outside her and put it in some context? In this particular instance, we chose to step outside a little bit to keep the score feeling slightly more intimate, slightly more connected and real for who she is, and yet give it enough impact so that when she has some of these impactful experiences, there's no doubt about the largesse, the truly life-changing decisions and experiences that she is having. So getting started on a film like Gracie, one has to pick an orchestration. Turned out to be maybe 30% of the movie is a 50-piece orchestra, and then we'd scale it down. Because in the beginning of the film, you don't even need that. It's a story of a young family growing up in New Jersey, and you don't necessarily need a bombastic orchestra to help you connect to these characters. You play with these things. You play with these things all throughout the process of scoring, or of writing, I should say. And again, a room like this gives me the opportunity to try things. I can mock up 4 French horns and 8 trombones, or I can go down to 2 trombones and 3 French horns, and we can play it, and the director can sit here and say, ooh, that gave me goosebumps. Let's do that. Of course, that's what you're going for. You're going for the, ooh, let's do that. Over these years of scoring many different types of films, I've had to teach myself a lot about music. I started off as a jazz trumpet player and an electronic music programmer. So there was a lot to learn about becoming a really fully educated film composer, a lot to learn about writing for orchestra. As I mentioned, a lot to learn about being able to predict the emotion that the music you're writing is going to evoke. It's been school for me, and one of the reasons that I continue to enjoy this job is that every film offers me another opportunity to go in and learn something more about the language of music. To make an intelligent movie that the whole family can see, I still think is probably one of the ultimate challenges in Hollywood, and I think Davis has done that with this movie, and it was just a joy to work on.